So every year at IQMR, I come to teach process tracing and typological theorizing, and I do that together often with David Waldner and Tasha Fairfield, and sometimes Jack Levy has come to talk about counterfactual analysis too.
So there's a whole menu of case selection criteria or rationales or approaches.
I love teaching Bayesian reasoning for qualitative research. So that's what my module is. This is my third year, and I love it. I'm Tasha Fairfield, and I am a professor at the London School of Economics, and I've been there for 7 years now. We're picking up on some of the ideas that Andy Bennett and Timothy McCune introduced. So we're drawing on insights from Bayesianism in the natural sciences to try and help improve the way that we use evidence to assess alternative hypotheses in a qualitative social science setting.
Including the sort of cross-national component, especially a quantitative component like a regression.
The main step in Bayesian inference is sort of taking a piece of evidence and trying to assess how much it favors your explanation relative to a rival. You want to sort of imagine sort of mentally inhabiting the world of one hypothesis and ask yourself, how surprising or expected would this evidence I found be if I imagine that world and the kinds of scenarios I would expect, relative to how likely or how surprising or expected would that evidence be if I imagine an alternative hypothetical world where the other hypothesis is true. So that's where the inferential weight comes from in this framework. So I have exercises where I work with case studies and I extract sort of concrete pieces of evidence from case narratives, and I select a couple hypotheses, usually the author's hypotheses and a major rival that they assess. And then I ask the students to go through this exercise of weighing the evidence and asking which explanation makes a given piece of evidence more plausible.
One of the challenges in teaching qualitative methods is that typically we haven't had like problem sets like statistical courses do, and that gets students thinking actively. And then I also try to have students volunteer to present their own research as examples of typological theories, and then they get feedback. And then we work through research examples. You know, when you teach methods, if you just taught at the very general abstract level, then it quickly loses people's interest. But if you can always bring it back to examples of research that are substantively important topics and show how particular researchers struggle with methodological issues and how they resolve them, then that's always intrinsically more interesting. So that's a really exciting part of it. But the process tracing module is sort of one of the key bread and butter things that I teach here at the Institute, and it often gets a terrific group of great students.